Hello everyone, today we will learn about how to perform a TLC with the help of animation. My name is Pritam Zuwatka, working as a HOD and academic in charge in Kokan Ganpit Rao Thakkar College of Pharmacy and Research Institute, Karzat, in the Department of Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry. So when we learn about the thin layer chromatography by animation, firstly we have to understand thin layer chromatography. So thin layer chromatography is a specifically mode of liquid chromatography in which what one is stationary phase is there, one is liquid phase is there. So when we think about the stationary phase, is a sorbent layer is there, that may be silica gel or it may be a cellulose, it may be polyamide, and it is been absorbed on the inert plate material, that is nothing but aluminium, glass or plastic. So when we think about this thin layer chromatography, so here the mobile phase is a single or maybe mixture of the solvent. So migration of the component means what we extract having a different phytoconstituent that may be run with the help of particularly we can say mobile phase. Migration time is same, but particularly migration distance may be different depend upon the affinity towards the mobile phase and stationary phase. So affinity depend on it will get segregated, it will get separated, and that is nothing but we can say nowadays the pre-coated material plate is also available, which is a silica gel, is nothing but coated on aluminium plane or we can say aluminium plate, and it is been utilized in at 110 degree Celsius for 1 hour. So that is nothing but we can say it is been preheated so that removal the water and moisture which has been present in a silica gel or surface of the silica gel. So retention factor is nothing but we are using a formula for that is RF value, and RF value for the each and every substance is different. Now that is the distance traveled by solute divided by from the baseline divided by the distance traveled by the solvent from the baseline. Silica gel plate we are utilizing is normal amount, you can see here 10 centimeter is to 4 centimeter, and now baseline you have to draw with the pencil, not use a marker or pen. Now we are for the spotting, we required a sub capillary to take a sample and spot it out. So capillary you have to burn at the center red hot, and then you have to pull it. So what will happen, it will form a needle shape, and then you have to prepare the mobile phase and keep it for the saturation. Now sample you have to take with the help of capillary. Each time you have to use a different capillary. You can see here, you can dip your capillary in the sample, and then you have to take a solvent and then keep it, make a particularly band on the specifically baseline which has been drawn with the pencil. You can see here that the needle is nothing but incorporating a liquid, that is standard spot has been made, one band has been made at the baseline, which is a 2 centimeter beyond or a mobile phase beyond, it depend on the mobile phase layer also. And then you have to place a sample and as well as a standard. Now mobile phase you have to keep your slide in the mobile phase in a beaker, and then automatically it will run. See, you can see here it is running. So it is run, then you have to 3/4 or we can say up to certain mark it has been removed. That certain mark or 3/4 distance is known as a solvent front. Then you have to dry that, and that solvent front you have to mark with the pencil. Again, you have to, after drying, you have to keep it in a developing reagent. So what will happen? The developing reagent will react that one, your spot or phytoconstituent, it will color the spot. Then again, you have to dry it. You can see here, you can dry that particular plate. Once you dry, it will get developed the color. Now you can see the standard as well as your samples. S is standard and A is a sample. You can see here the marking is nothing but same as that of we can say standard, means what, your drug is having that constituent which belongs to the standard. So it will show the mark. In some of the we can say you won't get it marks, so that is very important. Now come towards the point, when you having RF value is a distance traveled by the solute from the baseline and distance traveled divided by the distance traveled by the solvent from the baseline. So that is very important. Likewise, you have to perform your TLC, and if your sample is showing the constituent, then same mark will be there in the S as well as in A. So thank you very much. Hope you understand. If you're not understand, please let me know. If any query is there regarding TLC, you can put it on comment box, or you can send me on my mail ID. So it's flashing over here. My mobile number is also there, so you can anytime you can contact me anytime. So thank you very much, and please join me on YouTube also. I'm having my YouTube channel, that is Pritam Zuwatkar, where you will get many of the nutraceutical as well as the pharmacognosy and biochemistry lectures. Thank you very much. Have a good day.